President Yoweri Museveni is now eligible to contest in the 2021 general elections after the Supreme Court ruled that Ugandans above 75 years and those below 35 years can contest for the presidency. In a long-awaited Supreme Court ruling, four justices led by the Chief Justice Bart Katureebe concurred with the ruling of the five justices of the Constitutional Court, who in July last year ruled in favor of the Parliament's decision to amend Article 102B on the presidential age limits.
By majority decision of 43, the decision of the Constitutional Court is upheld. This appeal therefore fails. 9, with regard to costs, it is the unanimous decision of this court that each party shall bear their own costs in this court.
The justices disagreed with the appellants, led by Elias Lukwago, Ladislaus Rwakafuzi and Wandel Ogalo, that by removing the presidential age limits, the basic structure of the constitution was destroyed, and that parliament had not followed its rules and procedures in processing the amendment bill, tabled by Igara West MP Rafael Majizi.
That sections 1, 3, 4 and 7 of the constitution amendment number 1 act of 2018 were passed in accordance with the constitution of Uganda.
I will dismiss the appeal. A consolidated appeal, and the parties shall bear their costs in this court. I would confirm the decision of the Constitutional Court.
I agree that the appeal should fail and that each party should bear their own costs. I also agree that the preliminary objections do fail for reasons she has given.
However, three justices, Lilian Tebate Mwaikiri Kubinza, Eridad Mwangusha, and Paul Mugamba annulled the amendment on grounds that the majority justices of the Constitutional Court wrongly applied the doctrine of sovereignty in their judgments. The justices ruled that the Constitutional Court should have annulled the amendment of Article 102B, as it did with the restoration of the presidential term limits, the extension of term of office for members of parliament and the president from 5 to 7 years, since all amendments were in Rafael Majizi's bill.
As the consequence of a number of acts that infringed on the constitution in the process of enactment of the constitution, the act cannot be allowed to stand and is hereby annulled.
The justices also concurred with the appellants that there were defaults in the certificate of compliance from the Speaker of Parliament to the President with a misrepresentation of the amended articles. This implied that the President did not assent to the exact bill passed by Parliament.
That the enactment of the law is a process, and if any of the stages therein is flawed, that vitiates the entire process and vitiates the law that is enacted as a result of it.
Despite all justices condemning the invasion of Parliament and torture of MPs by security forces, they four maintained that the acts of the security forces did not warrant the annulment of the amendments and advised the affected MPs to seek redress from the High Court.
By not finding that the members of Parliament who were arrested and detained after their suspension were maltreated by security forces and their right freedom from torture and human dignity violated. However, it is my finding that this in itself did not affect the passing of the Amendment Act.
This Supreme Court ruling comes after both the NRM Central Executive Committee and Parliamentary Caucus endorsed Museveni as the party's sole candidate in the 2021 general elections. Herbert Ziwa, NTV.